Don't worry guys, you haven't been clickbaited. This laptop actually destroys MacBook. Okay, I switched from my MacBook Air M3 to this laptop almost 2 weeks ago, and I must tell you that I have never been this impressed with a Windows laptop. But how did it happen, and what is so special about this laptop? Well, you see this sticker? Yes, this one. That's the secret ingredient that has changed the game completely. Okay, so this is the Asus VivoBook S15 OLED, and it's one of the first laptops to be powered by the all-new Snapdragon X-Elite ARM-based processor. The big transformation from x86 to ARM-based processors has finally happened in Windows, and it's looking promising so far. The performance of the X-Elite processors is not just better than Intel or AMD, it's in fact giving tough competition to the M-series chipsets as well. And that's something we didn't see coming. Let me just take you through the specs and the benchmarks first. So the laptop that we have with us is powered by an entry-level X-Elite processor, and it's based on a 4-nanometer architecture, comes with 12 CPU cores clocked at 3.4 GHz, Adreno GPU, and a Hexagon NPU. Plus, it's paired with 16GB LPDDR5X RAM and 1TB M.2 SSD. The RAM is soldered, but the storage can be upgraded up to 2TB. Unlike MacBooks, we also ran benchmarks to see where this laptop stands against the competition. All the tests were done on both power and battery, but the results didn't change much. For the TDPs, there are 4 different performance profiles, and we did our testing in 50W mode. Plus, the laptop was on the best performance mode throughout the benchmarks. Okay, so in Geekbench single core, the results were similar to Core 7 Ultra, but not too far from the M3 or 13th gen Intel Core i9. But in multi-core, X-Elite lives up to its elite name and scores second best. In Cinebench R24 as well, the multi-core scores are way high compared to M3. Storage speeds are also decent, and these are the 3D Mark and Puget Bench scores. And yeah, for the GPU, well, the Geekbench GPU scores are not that impressive. And if I talk about gaming, well, it's one area where ARM processors lack a lot. First of all, anti-cheat software is not supported on ARM, so games like Fortnite and Valorant are completely unsupported. Even the rendered couldn't load at all, even after trying multiple times. I did try out GTA 5 and it ran at 60 FPS in normal settings, and in Rocket League, the FPS was around 90 to 120 in 1080p, but CS2 was unplayable even at the lowest setting. That said, I think the gaming situation will definitely get better as more laptops start launching with ARM-based processors. Because the chipset is definitely capable of handling games, it's just that the developers need to add support from their end. But the good thing is that the laptop doesn't get warm, as the dual heat pipes and dual fans keep it cool, even while running benchmarks are doing power-intensive tasks. Other than the gaming, the laptop performed quite well for me. I didn't face any slowdowns throughout my usage. At any given times, I have like 50 to 70 Chrome tabs alongside Slack, Notion, WhatsApp, and Spotify. This laptop handled it all without any issues. I also tried Photoshop and it worked well, but sadly, all the other Creative Cloud apps are not supported on ARM as of yet. Even a basic app like LocalSend that I rely a lot on couldn't be installed on this laptop. See, it's not a fault of the laptop or the processor, it's in fact a problem that was bound to happen because it's a big change. As more laptops launch with ARM-based processors, the app support will definitely increase and these problems will be resolved. For now, I'll leave a link to the website that has all the compatible apps and games, and while you're checking it out from the description, press that like button as it means a lot to us. So in terms of performance, this laptop gives a tough competition to the MacBook Air M3, but there's one area where this laptop stands really tall, and that is the on-device AI. First of all, you can get live captions for any video or movie you're playing on screen. It's quite useful and works well. Secondly, if your drawings look good in your head but bad in reality, well, not anymore, because with Co-Creator you can transform your sketches into exhibition worthy art in real time. There's also AI noise cancelling for video calls that works well, adaptive dimming, adaptive lock and more, and of course there's Co-Pilot, which is pretty useful too. Apart from the performance and the AI features, there was one more thing that I was specifically interested in, and that was the battery life. See, both Apple and Asus claim 18 hours of battery life, but I was getting around 10 to 11 on the M3 and I got 12 hours on this one. I wasn't really expecting it. Even the standby drain was just 2% over 15 hours. Here's a timeline of how the battery drained from 100% to 5% over the course of 2 days to give you a proper idea. And if you're wondering, it's a 70Wh battery with a 90W Type-C charger in the box that takes the laptop from 5 to 100% in just 100 minutes. In terms of battery life, it's probably the first time that a Windows laptop has beaten a Mac. Historic moment, isn't it? Now, it's time we talk about the rest of the laptop. design and display first. It looks stunning with this minimal all-metal design. You can also open it with one hand, just like MacBook, and goes all the way to 180 degrees, unlike MacBook. It's pretty thin and lightweight, so it's quite portable. Plus, it's also military-grade certified, which is always good, especially for someone like me. But most importantly, it has all the ports you need. There are two USB-A ports, two USB-C ports, a headphone jack, HDMI 2.1, and even a microSD card reader. MacBook, on the other hand, doesn't believe in ports. It mostly relies on dongles. On a serious note, not having all the ports on a Mac is a problem that I constantly face on my MacBook. But I'm just glad that Asus didn't mess up the basics. And now, the display. It's a beautiful 15.6-inch 3K 120Hz OLED panel with 100% DCI-P3 coverage and 600 nits of peak brightness. It's sharp and smooth to use, and watching movies on it is a treat. The speakers aren't the best, but they are decent with good clarity and certified by Harman Kardon. Now, in front of an OLED panel like this, the 60Hz LCD panel looks boring. Lastly, the keyboard is RGB backlit, there's good amount of key travel, and the numpad is useful too. Now, the typing experience on this laptop didn't feel any better or worse compared to MacBooks, but having a full-size keyboard is definitely more convenient. Plus, there's one additional key that you won't find on Macs, and that is the Copilot key. Pretty convenient for frequent use. And for the trackpad, Asus has a bigger and better trackpad that offers a lot of useful gestures to control brightness, volume, and even media playback. I think every laptop should have these because they are pretty useful. Finally, there's a 1080p webcam on the front with IR face unlock support, and the video quality here is pretty great, as you can see. And this is how the video looks from the Mac. You decide. Now, to conclude things, the Asus VivoBook S15 costs 1.25 lakhs, while the MacBook Air M3 with the same RAM and storage option costs 1.75 lakhs. And not just that, Asus offers a much better display, almost same performance, slightly better battery life, some useful AI features, and a dongle-free life. Of course, there are some compatibility issues right now, but it will be resolved as more ARM-based Windows laptops come to the market. So let me put it this way, the Mac vs Windows game has changed, and the ARM-based Windows laptop are definitely going to give a good competition to Mac. And for the price, the Asus VivoBook S15 definitely offers a lot more value than the MacBook Air M3. So what do you guys think of this Snapdragon laptop? Tell us in comments. If you guys have any more questions about this laptop, feel free to ask and we'll answer them. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.
Destroys MacBook.